You need to have sabr when you read the Quran. Every deed that you do requires sabr. Your salat requires sabr. Your fasting requires sabr. Your tasbih requires sabr. Every deed that you do requires sabr. Well, Quran is no different. When you read the Quran, it requires sabr as well. And don't expect an effect to happen overnight. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills that, it happens. But what is expected from you is that you continue in your recitation of the Quran and you don't give up. Even if you've set an expectation for yourself that I expect to finish a juz'at every night. And by now it's 9:05, I haven't even got to that expectation. Allah, let me just close off and we'll see it next Ramadan. Don't do that. This is the plan of the shaitan, exactly. This is why before you read the Quran, you say, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. And when you say that, you're asking Allah to protect you from ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Be conscious when you say, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Be conscious of the fact that it is ash-shaytan ar-rajim that is standing between you and the relationship with the Quran. It's a shaitan al-rajim that stands between you and opening this Quran and starting to read and continue to read. It's a shaitan that stands between you and this Quran. For when you say, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan al-rajim, feel it in your heart and take a time, take some time to read, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan al-rajim. Because if Allah Azza wa Jal was to accept this dua from you, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan al-rajim is a dua. You're asking Allah to protect you from ash-shaytan. If Allah was to accept this dua from you, you'll find yourself on a highway with the Quran. You'll find yourself going forward with the Quran. And then before you begin to read, you say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the all merciful. When you read this name, Ar Rahmanir Rahim, when you read this name of Allah, realize and understand this is where you're going to find the rahmah of Allah. This is where you're going to find the mercy of Allah. And this is the garden of His mercy and the garden of His blessing. This is where the kindness and the compassion and the gentleness and the mercy is found within this book. And then you begin to read. And one very important tip that you're supposed to do as you read this Quran and begin to draw nearer and nearer to this Quran, convert every ayah into a dua. Convert the ayat you read into a dua. So when you begin and you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, and you realize and you understand that Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim are two names of Allah Azza wa Jal, stop there. Or raise your hand and ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bestow His mercy upon you. You read Maliki Yawm al-Din, the King and the Owner and the Master of the Day of Judgment. Stop and say, Oh Allah, make that day easier upon me and my family and the Muslims. Iyaka na'bud, You alone we worship. Stop and say, Oh Allah, A'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Help me and aid me and support me to continue in your worship. And every ayah like this, stop and make a dua. And don't use the excuse that, what about if I don't know what I read? 100% you've already known and you come across words like an-nar, al-jaheem, al-jannah, maghfirah, azab, sayyat. When you come by these words, which you know their meaning, stop. Wa ask Allah Azza wa Jal for the paradise and ask Him for His mercy, ask Him for His forgiveness. Ask Allah Azza wa Jal when you read. This is how you begin to draw this relationship between you and the Quran. Why? Because when you read the Quran, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to you. And when you make dua, this is you speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when someone speaks to someone else, he expects a response from him. This will enhance your relationship with the Quran and it'll take it to another level and it'll keep dragging you and bringing you closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.